Hey guys, welcome to the software slash setup and inputs and outputs part of this video. We're going to touch base on a dual PC setup. So hopefully this will answer a lot of your questions on the simplicity and complexity of actually setting up this mixer, and also give you some free tips and pointers on how to get this working for you and the fastest possible way without pulling out your hair, which I already did. So I did all the hard work for you. Enjoy. We'll start off by going on the gaming PC. Now, keep in mind, all that's plugged into the gaming PC is the GoXLR mixer itself through the USB port. On top of that, we've got the microphone plugged directly into the mixer. Then on the gaming PC, you also have your headphones that you're going to be listening to everything with. So let's start over here with the sound. And your main output is going to be the system, the GoXLR. Normally it's your speaker out. So you'll always choose the system, and that is the main output of the computer. So you'll hear just about everything that the system plays as far as YouTube or the game that you're playing. And that will be your master out. All right. Next, you're going to have your input, and that's the microphone. From the mixer, it's a virtual line that's basically the chat mic. But the mic is actually plugged into the mixer itself, so keep that in mind. It's not actually plugged into the computer. So it's microphone, mixer, computer. And you'll choose the chat mic. Next, we've got the software itself. You're going to have the mixer here. All your different mic, chat, music, game, console, line-in, system, and sample. Now, all these are obviously adjustable for your to set your various volumes, but only four of these you can choose as at your fingertip control, right? You've only got four sliders at the top of the mixer. So this is where you set it over here with your faders, channel 1, 2, 3, and 4. And in the source list, you just pick which one you want. Now for this particular setup, let's go over the sources and what channel I have it set to, so you can understand what worked for me. It's not the same for everybody. So channel 1, I've got the microphone. So if I reach over and I push the mute or adjust the slider right at my fingertips, that you adjust right there on the software. You can see it moving. And basically when I hit mute, now you can hear me. So ideally, this will be personal preference. Remember, this is not how you have to set it up for the four sliders. You'll use what works for you. This video is just the tips that you need to understand the inputs and the outputs, and also where to channel all your information through to get to the mixer, to your live stream, and onto your game as well. Channel 2, we've got the music. Now, the reason I chose music is because there's a program that you want to download, and that is called, it's in the Microsoft Play Store, whatever you call it. Being an Apple guy, I'm not a professional on the Windows lingo, but I get by. So with channel 2, I've got the music. The program you want to go download is called Ear Banana. So if we open that up, over here, you've got your pop-up, and normally it looks like a speaker, but I've already chosen, if you right-click on it and you go to settings, check off the box, use legacy EarTrumpet icon. If you uncheck that, it goes to a speaker, then you have two speakers that look the same. It gets a little confusing. So I just checked that off, so it's the classic EarTrumpet logo. And when you open that, you get a whole slew of active inputs, outputs, and where you want them to go. The only reason I installed this and I set this up is because I wanted to designate Google Chrome going out the mixer or the music, so that I can set the music slider, which you saw right here, and it's channel 2 on my mixer. So I set that so that when I go to routing, can uncheck it from the stream. So if I want to listen to music personally or whatever on Google, I can put it to just the headphones, which is ideal, right? You want to have full control over those, but at the same time, if I wanted to send it to my chat, all I got to do is jump in here and check that off, and the Google Chrome will go to the live stream, which is also your system, your main, your line out that goes to the PC, the streaming PC. All right. Next on line three, we have the voice chat. Now, the voice chat is easy and simple. It's very straightforward. Whatever you set up in your inputs and outputs of the particular game that you're playing, first you'll choose for chat the microphone, and for the output you'll choose game chat. What this does, it allows you, if you get into a lobby or different things like that where they're getting toxic, you can quickly just press mute, adjust their volume. If the noise is too high or too low, you can just reach over and manually adjust that quickly at your fingertips and easily. So that gives you the control over the voice game chat, and obviously it's an independent channel from everything else, and that's the sweet spot of this whole mixer. Channel 4 we're going to jump over to is the main system. So this is the main output of this gaming PC. If I go over here and open up sound settings again here, which was already open, I just opened it again. The choose your output device right here, system, tc-helicon, GoXLR. So that is our main output. So everything that the computer does for audio is going to come out channel 4. And that's my very last slider that I have. Now you can play a video, anything you open, your game audio, that is all going to go straight out to the system. Now the nice thing about that routing is you can designate what is allowed to go to the system on your outputs. So here's the system, so you can have the stream. So yes, I want the stream to go out of the mixer and back over to the streaming PC. Your voice chat output, you've got headphones, and you got sampler. So if I was going to, let's say, record some wave files and put them to the sampler, which for those that don't know what a sampler is, it's basically a little quick tape recorder, or pulling out your phone and hitting record, but it's basically for you to click blurbs or sound effects or whatever. So wherever this is checked for the sampler, this is where it's going to play out of. So line in, if I choose, let's see, I'll give you an example here. So these are all your inputs. So the microphone is going to go to the sampler. The microphone is going to go to the headphones. The microphone is going to go to the voice chat. Mic is going to go to the stream. If you uncheck any of these, then the microphone won't go to those locations. Voice chat's going to go to the stream. Voice chat in, remember. So, and then voice chat in is going to go to the headphones. So, for example, if you didn't want to hear yourself speaking into the microphone, you would uncheck the headphones under mic. Boom. It's that simple. So that's my layout right there. Obviously, voice chat in, I would probably check off also for the sampler. If you're playing a game with somebody and you wanted to record them, you would check that off so that you could capture their voice where they're like, oh wow, you did it. You could quickly hit the button, record them saying that, and then just at the tap of the button of the sampler button on the mixer, play that back into the chat. So if we look at these again, voice chat in is going to also be allowed to go to the sampler, as well as my mic. So if I wanted to record my voice saying something without having to continuously say it and just use it as a record feature, I can also utilize the mic input. So that is the main four channels that we've got set up. Now let's head on over to the streaming PC, where we've got a whole different setup. Now the ins and outs are the easiest. Remember that you're just going from the mixer in and out, like right into. But let's just switch over to the screen. And if you look under sound settings, you've got the speakers as your main out. Obviously, that is your speaker output with a 3.5 millimeter jack going from there. Now, here's the key point. This is a big tip right here. You want to pick up, even when you order a mixer, and you know what? This is huge because it delayed me a few days to actually enjoy the mixer because it had noise. You need a ground loop noise isolator if you're going to use this mixer. It gets rid of all that noise and filters out the buzzing, and you just hook two computers together and you just get that negative feedback all the way through. So the ground is causing a lot of static and noise. So make sure you pick up, for the setup, you need three. Now every one will be different for the headphones, but my headphones are wireless. They plug into the wall, then I've got the little charge box. They're the Steel Series. So you'll want to make sure you know what you're using, but definitely at least two of these for the line in and out from the gaming PC over to the streaming PC. There's the ear trumpet. We'll get to the VB audio cable there, the virtual cable. Now look, if you see the line in, that is what you choose for the input. Now line in is obviously the output from the mixer. The speakers is out from the streaming PC, line in on the GoXLR mixer. But before you go to those, make sure you go through the noise filter, that ground loop isolator. That's a must. Trust me on this one. You'll save yourself a little bit of headache. So that's the in and out. It's easy. It's two cables and the two ground loop isolators. Next, we're going to head on over to Streamlabs. And this is just an example with Streamlabs because it's what I use. Other people might be using XSplit or OBS or whatever. But all you do in Streamlabs, what I used to have is my mixer window on the far right where the line in is. You would see a whole bunch of different channels of audio because that's just the way I could control it, maintain it, and have independent control of my sliders, right? So after switching to the GoXLR, I got rid of all of them. The only thing left is line in, because that's all that I want. I want the mixer to do all the work and the Streamlabs just to capture the audio of all the work the mixer's doing. So we just jump over to here under settings and you go to audio and disable all of them except for mic and auxiliary device, line in. Bang, Streamlabs is done. It puts a line in into all your scenes right here on the far right, which is fantastic. It's easy and simple. Getting back over to the VB audio software, you saw the VB-audio.com. This virtual cable is very important if you want to have a recording and playback device that's independent to itself, where you can control where it goes and if it's on or off, as well as its own independent volume. Now, the reason for that, I'll give you a quick example. I use Discord over on the streaming PC. So here, as my output, I have chosen that virtual voice meter input, the VB audio. This allows me to send it, to turn it on or off, for me to hear it, or the stream to hear it. Which is huge, because if you're doing something in Discord that you don't want going to your stream, then you want to make a separate way of being able to turn that on and off or where you're going to route it. Now, being able, the way that this is set up, there's no way to change where it's being routed because it's just going to go out the line out of the streaming PC back to your mixer. But what it does allow you to do is turn it on and off so that it doesn't go to the stream. All right, so if you wanted to send just your Discord to your scene, you would add that source, audio output capture or an audio input capture. Obviously, it's an output. So we add source and we choose, let's give it the name of Discord audio and add that source to it. Then we're going to choose which one it is. Obviously, it's the VP. So if that makes sense, I hope it helps a lot because it was very confusing for me at first, just trying to understand that anything, your masters out are going to be captured, and if you need that to be a separate input or output, make sure you understand your ultimate setup is putting Discord over on the gaming PC, then you can choose to have just you hear it or the stream and or both, right? Very easy. Okay, so that covers the virtual audio input output. Same thing with the virtual audio input using the EarTrumpet over on the gaming PC. It's just you could use either one. I mean, if you like this and it's simpler for you, you could install this to both the streaming and gaming PC, but then it just gives you the option to use just the one. Where this is actually, let's rephrase that, because this is creating a virtual input output, right? Whereas Ear Banana is just allowing you to choose which software goes to which input or output, right? So make sure that you understand the difference. They're kind of two different things, but at the same time, you're able to choose where it goes on the Ear Banana. Whereas this is actually creating you a new input output, all right? So you could possibly require to install VB virtual audio device cable on both of them, actually, on your streaming PC and your gaming PC. Then also install Ear Banana on both. Then it just gives you that ultimate full control of where you want to send stuff, if you want it enabled or disabled. And the reason that you would want it disabled on one is so that the stream doesn't hear it, right? So, not only do you have to set up your Streamlabs, that's Discord, you got your Streamlabs, and then once you've got your Streamlabs all set up, you've also got to create a bot or whatever your favorite utility is going to be, but sometimes that bot will have audio or whatever, and you'll need to send it to your stream as well. So it's simple. You just go under settings of your bot or whatever you're using, and you'll choose the speakers out. Obviously, that's going to send it out to the mixer, and whatever the mixer hears goes to your stream. All right. All right, I think that does it. We've got the routing covered. These are your inputs, your outputs. You've got your sampler. You can tell it where you want your sampler to listen, so that these are the locations it can record from, as well as where it's going to send it out, right? So output and input are key to understanding that you have full control over that through the mixer. And every once in a while, you know, you might, because you only have the four sliders, you might have to jump in here and, you know, your system sound or your game sounds a little too loud and it doesn't happen to be on one of your sliders, so that will have to be adjusted. You have the option to mute. When you hit the mute button, mute the stream only, or mute voice chat, mute the headphones. So when you hit mute, that particular channel, those are your outputs, right? There's three of them: your stream, your voice chat, and your headphones. If you do all, then it will do all of them, right? It's basic, it's simple. Go back to your routing. Here's the ones that were posted there. The only one it's not listing is the sampler, obviously. You don't need to mute the sampler. So mute the stream, mute the voice chat, mute the headphones, or mute all. Aside from that, your mic is pretty explanatory. You set that up how you like it accordingly to your voice. It took a lot of trial and error because before I was looking into this, I had it set up on a single PC. You know, it worked, it was strenuous. That didn't work for me. I switched to dual piece streaming PC, and then I tested the software end of it so that I could have control over everything. So I wanted control of all my channels, all my audio, manually on the screen. But you know, I was using that virtual banana, let's see, look it up here. Voice meter banana. So it was great. It's got a lot of options in it. Don't get me wrong though, it is very confusing to set up and it takes some tweaking. But every once in a while when I'd run that software, I'd have to go up to the menu right in midstream and restart the audio engine. It would just like go all digital and sound bad. So keep that in mind if you're not looking to do external hardware. Software stuff can be a little buggy. Aside from that, it works. But the GoXLR, guys, that is the way to go. And you're welcome to jump over to our website, mikesplace.ca, and order your own right from our website. We are Canadian, and that is Canadian funds. If you're in the States or otherwise, I do recommend you buy it from a local dealer that is able to ship not so far or cross borders. The GoXLR mixer comes in at 600 Canadian, and it is absolutely the best at your fingertips control for a lot of fun. You know, you've got so many features with the sampler and the voice changer and quick mute buttons, a cough mute button, and you're just not going to go wrong with having these kind of controls at your fingertips. The price is up there. It's not for everybody. It's for the guys that just really, really love what they do and do it for a purpose. So that is this video wrap up on this segment. This video and unboxing and review took me a long time to do and piece together, obviously. You can tell throughout the video, it's totally different days, different segments, my stream, and streaming live with it in action. But obviously, I hope I covered everything. It's been a long video. I do apologize for the different audio. We had the original, the Blue Yeti, and then we went, grabbed a segment of audio from the SLR camera, and then into the Shure, the SM7B mic. So that's what you're hearing now is actually the stream mic. It's the stream setup. It's working. I haven't had a whole lot of issues. A couple of times I did go to mute button and it wouldn't go back up. So I don't know if it was just a bug or a glitch. Another thing I wanted to point out that just came to me is make sure as you're setting up this mixer, you go over to profiles at the top. Create the one that you're editing, and then every 5 minutes, 10 minutes, if you're making lots of edits but it's where you like it, create a backup. If you unplug this mixer and you don't have a recent backup, you're starting over. So as you go and as you're creating, you know, your mic settings and you like it, jump over to profiles, click Fortnite or click backup and hit save, and just keep saving it. I just noticed too, like when we were doing this video, I'll give you a quick example. The sampler, this was empty. And when I set this up originally, it wasn't empty. So that makes a lot of sense. You want to be sure that you're hitting that save button. Just like this, overwrite, yes. You go to the backup if you haven't made huge changes or it is what you like, hit save. That way you've got two. You know, if you jumped in here, made a whole bunch of changes, and you're like, oh, I didn't like that, you can always go back to your backup, restore it, and start fresh from the last one that you were using that you did like. Just another free tip on doing that. Now, I did say earlier you might want three of those ground loop isolators. For this setup, I'm using the Steel Series, the wireless that comes with the battery charging hub. It's got a volume control in the front. It only grabs 5 volts USB. It's normally USB and plugs to the computer and detects the audio, and you can choose it as a headphone output. But for this setup, you have to use it separately. So you're going to take the box and plug it into a 5-volt source or right into the computer. As the DC in, not as the actual USB connection that it uses for the driver and the USB connection of the audio. Then you're gonna take line in on the back of the microphone, and you're going to send that right out to the headphone in on the mixer. But in between there, you're gonna want that ground loop isolator. That's not for every pair of headphones, and all I'm saying, for $12, you might as well just bring in an extra one and get your setup done properly. We will have links in the bottom if any of this stuff is helpful. You can help us back for the time we spent to create this video by using our referral links through Amazon or buying the mixer from us at our shop if you're in Canada. It helps us out a ton. We're spending time to do these things to help you guys out, and it's firsthand. I've gone through the problems, I've gone through the trials, and hopefully it just saves you hours of time and effort to do this. So that is it. If you have any other questions or comments, be sure to leave them in this comment section below. Do subscribe, click that bell, know when we've uploaded a new video. We don't spam our channel. I am very erratic all over the place, whether I'm streaming or creating video or taking care of 6 kids, being that perfect husband for my wife, or even just going to work 9 to 5, right? It's a busy life. I do try to stream as much as I can and create a community there as well. It's slowly growing, but many hours of work, but I love it. It's fun. You get to set an example, you get to be an example, and at the same time, I'm doing it with my son, and he's having a blast helping me and working with me, and we just have fun. So I think that's what it's all about, as well as reaching out to the community and helping others, and sometimes you see that help come back. So I hope this helped. as part of the segment of the video of the software setup, your inputs and outputs, is come to a close for this particular setup. Remember, I did say it's not the same for everybody, especially if you're running a single PC setup, but it'll be close as far as your inputs and your outputs and your routing of the software goes. So everybody, I want to thank you for watching this part of the video. Peace and God bless.